In this video, we want to demonstrate how to place the manually placed Elliott Wave tool as well as the Gann Fan within Track and Trade. Now, the first thing I want to point out is that we have two Elliott Wave tools in Track and Trade. The one we're going to focus on is the manually placed Elliott Wave tool in this example. If you wanted the automatic Elliott Wave tool, you would right click on the chart, you would come down to Chart Overlays, and you'd have the zigzag / Elliott Wave tool here. This would be the automated method. But in this example, we're talking about the manually drawn method. The manually drawn method is a reoccurring price pattern, which is the Elliott Wave, and we example that or highlight that by using the manually placed Elliott Wave tool by clicking here. If we come down, we start with the Elliott Wave and we start to highlight the different points that we want within the Elliott Wave to highlight in our drawing. We do it like this. If we come to a point where we decide we want to change our mind and we don't want to draw it anymore, or we feel like we've done the wrong thing, the way we stop drawing is simply right click and it will delete the existing drawing and you can start over. This is the same with almost every tool in Track and Trade. By right clicking while you're halfway through drawing a tool, it will delete it so you can start fresh again. So let's load the cursor once again, click the Elliott Wave tool, and we're going to slide up here and we're going to place the Elliott Wave tool in here just by clicking each one of the points that we want to highlight as one of the Elliott Wave points. Elliott is a traditionally 5-wave pattern with an ABC retracing pattern, so we highlight it in this way. So we just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, ABC by using the left click button. And we can adjust any of these points just by moving them by clicking on them and dragging them later. Of course, if we have the preferences tab selected, we have all the different preferences available to us for that particular tool, and in this case we can come in here. We can change the color, we could change the line style or the line thickness, we could come in, we could change the font size, maybe we want to make it bold, the different style text that we want to have on there, maybe we want to change it to a different size style text. We have little arcs that we can show. You'll notice that there's little arcs in there, you can either turn those on or off. We have the snap to capability, which snaps it to the individual price bars or makes it free flowing. I kind of like the snap turned on, it allows us to snap to a particular price bar level, or always show the lines. If we turn that off and then when we deselect the tool, you'll notice the lines go away. When we select it, it brings back the preferences for that tool. We say always show the lines when we select it. Now when we undeselect the tool, you'll notice the lines remain. To remove the tool from the screen, very simply, all we have to do is select it, make sure the handles are highlighted. We can either right click and say delete the tool, or we can simply highlight the tool, hit the delete key on the keyboard, and it deletes it as well. So the next tool that I want to highlight is the Gann Fan. The Gann Fan is right here on the button bar. If we click that icon, it's going to load the cursor with the Gann Fan, and we can simply find the lowest point of the trend, draw to the highest point of the trend, and it's going to give us the Gann Fan. Very simply put. Now, many people like to square the Gann Fan, so I'm going to show you how to square the Gann Fan. To remove the Gann Fan, the current Gann Fan that we have on the screen, I'm going to right click and hit delete, remove that Gann Fan. The next one I'm going to draw, I'm going to square. So I click the Gann Fan, I load the cursor with the icon, I start at the lowest point and I begin drawing and I hold down the left mouse button, and as long as I'm holding down the left mouse button, you can notice that the Gann Fan is dynamic and will fit whatever structure that you would like it to and go to whatever points that you would like to point it to. But if you would like to square the Gann Fan, hold down the control key while you're doing the drawing and it will hold it squared to the current chart scaling. Okay, so it'll remain squared, and then you can square the Gann Fan to the particular price level. And this is a method in which Gann would use to square his chart, square his drawing to the chart. And so this is a method in which you can do the same thing in your computer software. Again, when this tool is selected, you have the preferences tab selected, you have the control panel which allows you to come in and make the changes that we have just did exampled over on the Elliott Wave tool. We can come in, we can change the lines, the styles, the colors, the background, the font sizes. We can also come in and do the same thing. We can show the text or not. We can extend the lines on the Gann Fan to go off the screen indefinitely. We also have the snap capabilities and the fill the background capabilities.